everyone, happy Flight Training Friday. So, to travel, you would take an automobile, a train, and obviously a gyrocopter. Lift. Yes, would you fly in a gyrocopter? We wanted to give you a little information on a possibility that's coming soon, hopefully sooner. But we're planning for it to be here around spring of 2018. Gary Bordeaux with Beach Flight has ordered a gyrocopter. We're going to give you some information on it and a little mock-up picture with his logo on it. Possibly getting a gyro and see if you would be interested in flying it one day soon. So yeah, so if you already have a private's license, you have to do is do a proficiency flight or several proficiency flights, and have to have two sign-offs from two different instructors saying that you were proficient to fly in a gyrocopter if you're already licensed and have at least a private pilot license. If you don't have any licenses, you'll need at least a light sport license with a gyrocopter category add-on or endorsement. So we're going to have a couple of pictures showing you from the regs, let you see what all is in detail for getting those licenses to be able to fly the gyrocopter. So, I have a picture, I'll let you see that here.
So here's the new gyrocopter, well, something like it. It's not going to have this color scheme or anything, but they just made a mock-up of what it would possibly look like with Beach Flight's logo. That's the concept of the new gyro. And this is from FAR 61.321 for anyone wanting to add on the category to fly the gyros. You'll be able to see that as far as the logbook endorsements from an instructor, where they have to train you, also completing the proficiency check with another instructor to sign you off in the areas for parts 61.309 and 61.311. And then once you have those two endorsements, then you'll fill out your application on IACRA to complete the process to update your new pilot's license. And then of course you'll need that final logbook endorsement from the instructor who conducts the proficiency check and so on. And to clarify from earlier, this is for anyone who already has a license, whether it's the sport or the private, wanting to add on privileges for the gyrocopter. And then if you don't have any licenses and you're wanting to get the sport with gyro class privileges, you'll need to get those 20 hours, the solo time, etc. with your cross-country hours. Your solo time, your solo cross-country time as well, training before the practical test and so on, before your 2 calendar months before your check ride. So that's pretty much it for getting those gyro licenses.
So yeah, if you're interested. So hopefully it gets here again around the spring of 2018. Gary has to get checked out and get comfortable with it so we're all comfortable flying in the gyrocopter before we put any students in it. And then hopefully we'll be here soon. And then we also want to give a shout out to Jacob Chafin, who finished up his private license with us on this past Sunday with examiner John Genesta. So he is off to ATP in Tennessee. So congratulations to him for passing his private check ride and good luck to him on his next license at ATP. So we hope you have a good week. Ours again is busy dodging thunderstorms and weather cells. So we hope to see you next week and have a good one. Bye.